The O'Neill World Cup of Surfing is a prestigious event in professional surfing held annually at Pupukea Sunset Beach on Oahu in Hawaii. The event attracts hundreds of elite surfers from around the world, and is known for its huge waves. It is the second tournament in the Triple Crown of Surfing. History. The first competition was held in 1975. Of the 22 surfers who have won the event, 7 went on to become world champions. This competition is the final stop of the 2010 Association of Surfing Professional Tour, and the ASPW Tour as well. Top performers of the event share a prize money that varies from year to year, along with points which go to the Triple Crown competition. Brazil's Rony Monteiro, 28, became the first South American male in 20 years to win the O'Neill World Cup of Surfing at Sunset Beach for 2010. Fabio Gouveia from South America won the title in 1991. Tyler Wright from Australia has won the Women's Cup twice, once when she was 16, and once when she was 19. Indiana 2005. Jake Patterson from Australia won his second O'Neill World Cup of Surfing title. In 2006, native Hawaiian resident, Makuakai Rothman won the O'Neill World Cup of Surfing, and took home $125,000 in prize money. In 2009, the winner of O'Neill event received $20,000, and the most consistent performer across all three Vans events received a $50,000 bonus. Topic: Vans Triple Crown of Surfing. The O'Neill World Cup of Surfing is presented by Rockstar Energy Drink and is the second jewel of the Vans Triple Crown of Surfing. The $740,000 Vans Triple Crown of Surfing consists of three different competitions held in Hawaii. They the Reef Hawaiian Pro at Haleiwa Ali'i Beach Park, November 12-24, the O'Neill World Cup of Surfing at Sunset Beach, November 25. Deck Point 6, Billabong Pipeline Masters Men, at the Bonsai Pipeline, December 8-20, and Billabong Pro Maui Women, Honolulu Bay, Maui, December 8-20, WCT. Not only do the winners receive up to $740,000 in prize money, but both the men's and women's Vans Triple Crown champions will receive a limited edition $25,000 Chevy Colorado truck. The men's champion will also receive a custom $10,000 Nixon watch. The Vans Triple Crown of Surfing is considered to be a surfer's ultimate test. Each competition offers different challenges. CJ Hobgood from the U.S., scored highest in the men's O'Neill World Cup of Surfing in 2008. The Vans Triple Crown of Surfing is made possible through the support of OP, Roxy, O'Neill, Rip Curl, Billabong, Surfing, Oahu's Turtle Bay Beach Resort, Hawaiian Airlines, G-Shock, the Honolulu Star Bulletin, Fox Sports Net, and Road Runner High Speed Online. Topic: Sunset Beach plays a vital role in women's surfing history. Laura Bleers changed the face of professional female surfing by competing in the all-male Smirnoff Pro competition in 1974 at Sunset Beach, Hawaii. After her appearance in competition, women became a normal feature the competitions accumulating in Hawaii. In 2010, Sunset Beach plays a vital role in women's professional surfing history when O'Neill sponsored the first elite women's world tour event. This event was the second jewel of the Vans Triple Crown of Surfing. The O'Neill Women's World Cup of Surfing competition took place at Sunset Beach, Hawaii, November 24 to December 6 in 2010, and continues to take place year after year during that same time at Sunset Beach, Hawaii. It is the next to last contest of the Women's Championship Tour. World Cup of Surfing Sunset Beach. O'Neill is playing a role in women's history by sponsoring the event. Randy Rarick is the executive director of the Vans Triple Crown of Surfing. He is extremely excited about the O'Neill Women's World Cup of Surfing event at Sunset Beach, and is even more excited about the future of women's surfing. The two surfers, Gilmore and Parkinson, lead the Vans Triple Crown title race. The winning female athlete would take home $100,000 as prize money. The event determined the top four women for the final pipe showdown. After the event, the 2011 World Tour was decided in Sunset. Topic: Women's 2010 results. Heat number 1 women's final. Topic: 2010 women's wave statistics. The O'Neill Women's World Cup of Surfing attracts elite female surfers from around the world. The competition is known for its big waves, and is the ultimate test. The competition takes days, so the conditions vary from day to day. Topic: Men's 2010 results. Topic: Men's 2010 wave statistics. Equals equals men's results 2007.